New Poco devices are coming this quarter, and more details about the Poco brand. If you haven't already subscribed, make sure you subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon to get notified of new videos. Hey peeps, what's up? Manji here, back with another video, and in this video we're going to talk about new details which we got from a recent interview which the new head of the Poco brand had with a few Indian websites. I have of course linked all those articles in the description of the video in case you want to check them out. So a few days back, the Poco brand announced that it is going to be a separate entity and it is going to be independent from Xiaomi. Who is the head of the Poco brand? C. Manmohan is the new head of the Poco brand. What do they mean when they say that Poco brand is now a separate independent entity? As per the articles, it means that the Poco brand is going to have their own separate product team, sales team, and marketing team. They will eventually have their own offices, but for now they're going to use Xiaomi's offices in India. The important word to note here is that they are saying Poco will be a separate, independent, legal entity. That means it will be registered as its own company, maybe trying to prove that, you know, we are not dependent on Xiaomi. However, the truth might be a bit different, and they're putting this across as if, you know, Poco is a new brand, they do not have enough resources. So what are the resources they're going to use from Xiaomi? For starters, initially they're going to use Xiaomi's offices in India, and they're going to use Xiaomi service centers in India along with the data servers they have in China. These are all the things which are, these are all the resources which Poco is going to use from Xiaomi. Another important resource which they are going to use is MIUI. When I read this, it got me cracking up. I was like, I called my doctor and said, hey dude, I think I need to come in for another eye test because either I am going blind or the rest of the world is blind. Why do I say this? I say this because, and I quote what C. Manmohan said. He says, some of my Poco fans say that it is much more stock Android-ish. We are talking about MIUI for Poco here. Who the fuck in the world thinks that MIUI running on Poco, which they call MIUI for Poco, is much more stock Android-ish? All you did was add Poco Launcher on top of MIUI and you think it is stock Android-ish? I mean, people can think it is stock Android-ish, but this is the head of Poco team making this statement. I don't know what kind of illusion you are living in that you think that the version of MIUI running on Poco with just Poco Launcher on top is stock Android-ish. Bullshit. Stop fooling people and trying to make useless statements. Do you even know what you just said? I mean no offense, but you clearly know that MIUI running on Poco is nowhere stock Android-ish. Wait, where the fuck is stock Android in MIUI? Just because you added Poco Launcher on top doesn't make it stock Android-ish. Oh well. I do think people need to realize what they're even talking about. Next important thing from the interview. They are going to continue supporting the Poco F1 now. Don't get your hopes up high. I don't think so it'll get Android 11 ever. It might get MIUI 12 based on Android 10, but I don't think so. The Poco is going to get Android 11. If it does, it'll be awesome and it will be great. But me personally, I don't think that is going to happen. Next thing, is the Poco brand going to compete with Mi and Redmi? Yes, they said they are going to compete with Mi and Redmi brands, which means you have another competitor. All in all, this is good news for Xiaomi in the end, because what is going to happen is they're going to sell more phones. My personal opinion is that they came up with this idea of spinning POCO into a separate legal entity just to get into the advertising part of it and tell people that we are separate from Xiaomi, whereas they are fully dependent on Xiaomi. This, I think, is history repeating itself. This is how OnePlus came into existence. They came out and said, oh, we are a new brand, right? We don't have the resources, we don't have money to advertise, so we're going to go by word of mouth advertising, only for people to realize that it's BBK Electronics which owns OnePlus. In fact, OnePlus was a spin-off from Oppo because Oppo failed in the United States. This is what is happening over here. Xiaomi wants to compete with BBK, and that is why POCO is now a separate brand, even though the maximum or most of the resources they're going to use is from Xiaomi itself. Just trying to fool the people with something new. Another thing is, when is the next POCO device coming? As per Seeman Mohan, we could see the next POCO device or devices in Q1 of 2020, which is this quarter, which ends in March. So before March of 2020, you will see POCO devices. The aim still is to offer value for money devices with top-end processors and large amount of RAM, no matter whether the touchscreen is good or not. Trust me, the number of people I get commenting on my videos about POCO F1 touchscreen issues is like way too much. They still haven't fixed it. So anybody looking to buy the new POCO devices, please, please, please wait for reviews to see whether the touchscreen is working fine or not. You can, of course, expect them to push out multiple devices. Rumor has it that you might see three devices from the POCO brand, which makes sense. So you might see something like a POCO F2 Lite, a POCO F2, and a POCO F2 Pro to compete in different segments. Are they concentrating on international markets? For now, going from what I have read in the interviews, they are trying to concentrate on India. Doesn't mean that the POCO devices won't launch internationally, just that they are concentrating on the Indian market for now. What is my take on all this? My take on all this is, I call bullshit. I say that Xiaomi is just trying to fool people by launching POCO as a separate brand. POCO F1 was very popular. They should have come out with the POCO F2 last year. They did not. They realized that, oh, maybe we missed an opportunity. How do we take advantage of the popularity of POCO F1? Let's make it a separate brand, try to compete with Realme from the BBK group, or try to compete with OnePlus as well with another device from Xiaomi, launch it as a POCO branded device, and then see where it goes. You know, Xiaomi is known for flooding the market with a device every 15 days, nothing new. POCO will be just another brand for Xiaomi. In the end, it's going to be profitable for Xiaomi because they will eventually sell more devices. What is your take on all of this? Do let me know via comments below. That will do it for this video. See you when I see you.